The James Webb Space Telescope has had a long and difficult development. It's more than 7 years behind schedule, and its price tag has nearly doubled. But the observatory is nearly complete. It's currently undergoing final testing and stowing before it ships to French Guiana for an October 31st launch. However, a new problem will probably delay Webb's launch yet again. But for once, it's not the telescope's fault. This time, the problem is with the launch vehicle. Welcome to Launchpad. I'm Christian Reddy, your friendly neighborhood astronomer. Now, the fact that James Webb may be facing yet another delay is disappointing, but doesn't exactly come as a shock. The observatory has turned out to be far more complex than expected, and it's already more than 7 years behind schedule since it was baselined in 2009. The most recent delay from March 2021 to October 31st was announced due to the slowdown from the pandemic and the sheer amount of work remaining to be done. Now it's looking like the launch may slip yet again, but this time it's due to a problem with the Ariane 5 launch vehicle rather than the telescope itself. And this is a surprise because Ariane 5 was considered to be the least risky part of the whole project. So today we're going to talk about what happened and what it's going to take to finally get James Webb into space. But first, I do want to thank Magellan TV for sponsoring today's video. If space telescopes are your thing, then I invite you to check out Hubble's Enduring Legacy, a documentary about the iconic telescope's history and what it has revealed about our universe over the last three decades. This documentary and many more like it are available at Magellan TV, which is a new streaming service founded by the filmmakers themselves. You can enjoy content on topics such as art, nature, history, and of course, space and science. And now Magellan TV is offering my viewers 30% off an annual subscription. That's a full year of Magellan for just $3.50 a month. And this offer applies to both new and returning subscribers alike. Simply visit the link in the description to claim your discounted membership today. News of this new, albeit not yet official, delay comes from a new report by the Government Accountability Office. GAO has been issuing annual reports on JWST since 2011. That was the year Congress nearly canceled the project because it was so over budget and so behind schedule, it wasn't going to launch until the year 2018. How quaint. Anyway, in its March 2021 report, the GAO notes that there's still a lot of work to be done on the observatory, and the project has already used up most of its remaining schedule reserves to deal with unexpected problems. At a May 11 press event, JWST program manager Greg Robinson acknowledged that, yeah, they were pretty much out of schedule reserves, but they're otherwise on track to having Webb ready for an October 31st launch. Fingers crossed. Now, the new report didn't find any red flags with the project, and it didn't have any new recommendations for NASA. So that's the good news. But it also reported on a new problem with the Ariane 5 rocket. The Ariane 5 is the European Space Agency's heavy launch vehicle. ESA is providing it as an in-kind contribution to the JWST project. So far, it's accumulated 109 launches since it first flew in 1996 and has a 95% success rate. Not only that, but the vehicle launches from Kourou, French Guiana, which is close to the equator. And that gives the launcher an extra push due to the Earth's rotation. That's a good thing because JWST is heading all the way out to the Sun-Earth L2 point. However, there appears to be some problems with the Ariane 5's fairing that, if not corrected, will almost certainly delay the launch beyond October. The fairing protects the payload as it accelerates up through the atmosphere. Once the vehicle reaches space, the fairing separates into two pieces and falls away. However, since the fairing separates in the vacuum of space, any air left inside rapidly expands as it depressurizes. NASA was concerned that air trapped inside the folded sunshield could damage it when the fairing jettisons. You know, like this. Okay, not like that. But the project is concerned that the remaining trapped air could stress part of the sunshield membrane and weaken it. Later on, when the shield is deployed, it's pulled taut so the five layers are spaced apart evenly. This is key to the observatory's survival because Webb is an infrared telescope. That means the sunshield has to do a lot more than just keep the telescope in the dark. It has to passively cool the telescope from 383 Kelvin on the sunlit side all the way down to 36 Kelvin on the dark side. If the sunshield fails, then the mission's over. So obviously NASA wants to protect the shield as much as possible during launch. Now the Ariane 5's fairing has vents around its base to allow air to escape during ascent. Ideally, the air completely escapes so that by the time the fairing separates, the pressure inside is equal to the pressure outside. But in reality, the air never completely vents out during ascent. In fact, as the rocket is accelerating through the atmosphere, outside air can leak into the fairing. Flight data from prior launches showed that the remaining air pressure inside the fairing was higher than the sunshield was rated for. So Ariane Space modified the vents ahead of its launch in February 2020. Flight data showed there was some improvement in the fairing's internal air pressure, but it wasn't enough to meet JWST's safety margin. So Ariane Space added larger vents and actuators to ensure they remained open throughout the flight. They also sealed off the internal honeycomb structure to prevent outside air from leaking into the fairing. This second modified fairing was tested on Ariane 5's launch in October 2020. It turns out the changes only reduced the internal pressure by half the desired amount. But armed with this new data, the project went back and determined that the sunshield and the other hardware could in fact tolerate more pressure than initially believed. So the project just added some extra reinforcing patches to one of the five sunshield membranes at key locations. That's the good news. However, according to the GAO report, the Ariane 5 experienced unexpected accelerations when the fairing separated from the launch vehicle. In other words, the fairing induced vibrations that were above the acceptable limits. These vibrations occurred on both Ariane 5 flights in February and August last year. Both flights launched communication satellites. The satellites were unharmed and safely reached their intended orbits. Now, as far as I can tell, Ariane Space hasn't confirmed that it was the modifications to the fairings that caused these vibrations, but the Ariane 5 rocket has remained grounded since the August 2020 launch. At the May 11 media event, Greg Robinson confirmed that there are two more Ariane 5 launches scheduled ahead of JWST. If there are no anomalies with those launches, JWST could be ready to go about 4 months after. The 4 months are needed to pack up the spacecraft, ship it to French Guiana, and integrate it with the launch vehicle. However, Ariane Space haven't announced new launch dates on their website yet. Spaceflightnow.com shows one Ariane 5 sometime in July and a second launch sometime in August. Even if the summer launches go off without a hitch, it seems unlikely that the Ariane 5 would be ready for JWST by October 31st. Now, it's tempting to wonder if Webb just could be launched on something else, like SpaceX's Falcon Heavy. Well, the answer is no. Ariane 5's fairing is 5.4 meters in diameter. That makes it the largest on the market. Even then, JWST barely fits inside when it's folded up. ULA's Atlas V 500 series uses the same fairing as Ariane 5, but it launches further north and can't lift as much payload. Besides, you'd presumably still have those vibrations when the fairing separates. Now, even if Atlas could launch JWST to L2, it would require a lot more time and money to switch launchers. And yes, I know Starship has a whopping 9-meter fairing, but we're not going to test out Starship with JWST. Besides, ESA's giving NASA the Ariane 5 for free. You don't turn down a free ride to L2. Anyway, for now, the rumors are that the launch would only be delayed by a few weeks. We'll see. The good news is that unlike a planetary mission, JWST doesn't have to wait for a narrow launch window to open, so they can launch as soon as everything's ready. And that's just as well because there's still a fair amount of work to be done, in particular on its final deployment tests. Once in space, the telescope must unfold itself into a precise sequence to deploy its solar array, high-gain antenna, the forward and aft sunshield pallets, raise the telescope tower, deploy the momentum flap, the sunshield, the radiator shades, the secondary mirror, the aft radiator, and the mirror wings. You know, I wonder if that's why it took so long to build. Testing these deployments on the ground is very tricky because the mechanisms are not designed to fight gravity while they're moving parts around. So each component requires special rigging to offset its own weight while it's moving. The rigging effectively renders that component weightless during the test. Unfortunately, there's no way to rig everything up all at once and do a full dress rehearsal, so each component has to be tested individually. As of late April, its sunshield passed its final deployment test, and its mirrors were commanded to open for the last time here on Earth. The next time those components are deployed, it'll be in space. So what else needs to be done? Well, at the May 11 event, managers said that following this test, engineers will stow the sunshield for flight and then tackle Webb's remaining tests. These include deploying and then restowing the two radiators, and one final extension and restowing of its tower. At that point, the observatory will be in its fully stowed configuration and get shipped off to Kourou. It'll actually be put on a ship and sail through the Panama Canal because it's now too big to fit inside of a C5 galaxy. Of course, there's still plenty that can go wrong, especially after launch and during deployment. And that's why the mission operations team at the Space Telescope Science Institute are practicing the deployment sequence to figure out how to deal with anomalies. However, there's no provision for servicing JWST once it leaves Earth, and there aren't enough spare parts to put another one together. There are no do-overs here. It either works or it doesn't. So yeah, it's easy for us to shake our fists at NASA and Northrop Grumman and now Ariane Space for delaying Webb yet again. But let's face it, we're sitting out here in the cheap seats and we're not able to do anything about it. The project team, on the other hand, are working diligently to get Webb ready for launch. And I'm increasingly optimistic that it's just not a matter of if, but when. I'd like to thank my Patreon supporters for helping to keep Launchpad Astronomy going, and I want to welcome my newest patrons, Andrew Galbraith-Ryer, Virginia Mayer, and David Montero, along with special thanks to my intergalactic and cosmological level supporters. And if you'd like to join me on this journey through this incredible universe of ours, well, please make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any new videos. Until next time, stay patient and stay curious, my friends.